Today I will take all of your only 2 minutes and sometime other time more time. Piyush sir, we are also with you to make railway engine a growth of India. Railway engine, a growth of India, we are with you. We also want the same. We are on the same line. I am an activist of the railway issue since last 20 years. And some railway officers also helping me unconditionally. We need to remove only 3 things from railways: corruption, inefficiency and deficiency. For example, we are with you for bullet train, all projects we are with you, sir. But also other end, we don't want to compromise the existing projects. For example, in Mumbai suburban section, sir, in last 4 years, railway track got fractured 525 times. In Mumbai division. Yes. And recent RTI reply, the railway track got fractured, it was welded. Again, welding failure and fracture, sir. Yeah. Yes. Second, we want female passenger safety. In Mumbai suburban, there are regular attack on the female passenger. Females being thrown out by robbers. Recently, one MBBS student was thrown out on Harbour Lane, sir. So, government railway police strength is 4,000. It was approved in 1982, sir. Government railway police in Mumbai strength is only 4,000. Approved in 1982, at RTI reply, 500 posts are vacant and railway police commissioner has returned to government, requirement more 7,200 police. Thank you.
The rail fracture and the bad quality of infrastructure that we inherited is something I spoke about earlier, which we are changing to accelerate the pace of replacement of worn out tracks. And I do understand that this is something which is the most pressing thing to be done, but I certainly can't do it overnight. I'm already facing a lot of flack from all of you for punctuality, for example. But punctuality is the straight casualty. When I aggravate the speed, I accelerate the speed of track renewal. Because track renewal entails a longer traffic block. And I tried to tell both my GMs that why don't you increase the nighttime traffic block so we can do track renewals and foot over bridges and all faster. They said, sir, office mein baithne nahi dega janta humko. The reality is that after all, we are also an impatient lot. We are not willing to wait for the action also to be implemented or give time for that to be implemented. And as regards to safety, I believe technological innovation will be far more important and effective than just keeping on adding a person in the coach. I think it's more important that we map out through CCTV cameras what's happening across the system. It'll both be a deterrent and it will help to apprehend the habitual offenders. So my own approach is slightly different than just filling up papers and vacancies. I'd like to reassess the kind of people we need to employ rather than just going through a simple process. I would like to bring technology and then bring people who can engage with that technology and provide better service to the commuters of Mumbai.
One or two simple questions. I think Yogesh has something to say.
Usually, I have two simple. One is actually asking for a solution. We are a regular travelers of Mumbai train, and whenever there is an incident that we lost our season ticket, there is no provision in the Railway Act to provide season ticket, the lost season ticket. So can that be done? Because I tried once and I failed. I mean, the time I was expected to spend to get a duplicate season ticket was more than the pass period. And second is another serious question about the future of the Parsik tunnel. It is a 102-year-old tunnel and it is in a very bad shape because of the encroachments and the continuous leakage from the hutments above. Can anything be done there?
As regards your first point on season ticket, till we have these paper tickets, frankly, I don't see any way we can give you a duplicate. Because we'll never be able to control the number of duplicates. And there is no way to check whether the original is also being used and the duplicate is being used. Prima facie, as it is, many of you are against Aadhaar, which could be one way to safeguard against this duplication. But
point. Sir, just one point.
You are not the belt also.
Sir, I will just one point. That's
supplementaries are when the chair allows it in parliament. But I have a better solution than that. I am trying to move into electronic tickets and electronic season passes, so there is no question of losing it. So I'm with this POS machine, I'm hoping that I can give all my ticket collectors also POS machines, and then you won't have to carry any pass. Your mobile phone, just like Prime Minister once said, ki aapka phone hi aapka batua hai, phir wo batue mein ticket bhi nahi rakhna padega, wo bhi aapke batue mein phone mein hi aa jayega.
Without Aadhaar.
So, well, I think some people need to be educated a lot about Aadhaar. I've got so much data here. I'll leave behind a copy for you to know more about. As regards the Parsik tunnel,
sir, actually, Dr. Tikal Hartmans have ordered me to move from the top of the tunnel. And we have also given a study to CSIR, Rutgers University. They have given us the technology, already tenders have been floated to make it waterproof, so the water should not seep into the tunnel. Already the tender is already floated. And I think before coming monsoon, this work we expect to be completed.
Good.
Mr.
Arun
Gandhari
has a question. And while he asks it, one question from me, which I think Mr. Shirish Chanbagh had asked. So he's pointing out that Konkan Railway alone, unlike other long distance trains, is not allowed to use their ticket for local travel. So can that facility be extended to Konkan Railway passengers as well?
Which means they'll come in on Konkan Railway and then travel locally.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry.
Chartered accountancy ka exam was simpler than this.
Sir, actually we give this facility wherever routes are same. Like if somebody is coming through Punjab mail from Igatpuri, Kalyan, NBT, if he gets down anywhere, he can come by the local train. Similarly, if somebody is coming from Konkan, from Panvel side, so he is allowed to use the same route. Like Panvel to Diwa, then comes he comes to the BT. Panvel to Diwa is different than coming by Harbour Line. The rule allows on the same route. From Diwa to CSTM, he can avail the local services. But their request is, I think it's a policy matter, he should be allowed to use Suburban on a different route. Because Panvel to VT Harbour route is different than what Konkan Railway follows, that is Panvel to Diwa to main line.
Maybe so, he can do it. Proposal pay to because there will be few passengers. It won't really work. So, go and get a ticket, it's not worth it.
We'll work on.
Thank you so much.
Good
idea.
क्वेश्चन था कि मुंबई में बुलेट ट्रेन ला रहे हैं, मेट्रो ला रहे हैं, और बांद्रा से कुर्ला जो रेलवे लिंक है जो 10 साल से पेंडिंग है, मैं कई सालों से फॉलोअप कर रहा हूँ, वो लिंक बन सकती है क्या? क्योंकि ओनली 1000 करोड़ उसका खर्चा है और 100 करोड़ लोग कुर्ला टू बांद्रा डेली हर साल उधर से यात्रा करते हैं, तो लिंक बनाने के लिए आप कुछ प्रयास करेंगे?
And then create a link between central and western. Because Bandra Kurla, if you look at the topography, we are all Mumbai citizens, that area is going to be very difficult to get a clear line to create a rail route. But it will be connected through metro going forward. So I think people will have to interchange and go through the metro. Sorry? फिर आप बोलोगे बुलेट ट्रेन का इकोनॉमिक वायबिलिटी नहीं है बंद करो तो
आई थिंक सुमेरा अब्दुल अली नॉइस एक्टिविस्ट हैज क्वेश्चन
बट दैट ब्रिंग्स मी टू अ क्वेश्चन पीपल आर विलिंग टू पे फॉर द मेट्रो एंड ट्रैवल एट दैट प्राइस पर इंडियन रेलवे में 1 रुपया भी बढ़ाता हो तो आप लोग तो आंदोलन करके स्टेशन जला देते हो
ask a question on noise pollution because I've been working on noise for many years. I met you in the past on noise. And I measured noise on the suburban railways in Mumbai, and I found that there's a whole lot of sources of unavoidable noise, which makes the new trains even noisier than the old trains in some cases. Because of the loudspeakers which I used, I have received hundreds of complaints in Mumbai about people, you know, they commute for long hours, they sleep in the train, they play in the train, they meet their friends, and they're disturbed by this noise. Now, I realize that there is some revenue collection because of it, but not at the cost of people's health. The other noise source which is very acute is these bhajan mandals, which again have received numerous complaints. The railways have come out with crackdowns, but they keep coming back and they create a lot of disturbance. You know, a lot of the rage in the trains could be also due to noise, because there's a strong link between noise and mental health and rage and all that. And the last reason for noise in the trains is bad maintenance of some types. Like, for example, in one train when I measured that the brakes were screeching, the noise levels went up above 100 dB. So I think these are things which, when we talk of modernization, the airport has become silent, we need the railways to become silent too.
Absolutely. I think the third point is certainly totally under my control, and which we will ourselves internalize, and we'll see what we need to do to address the third point. For example, one of the decisions Sucheta had taken was across the country, we are eliminating all unmanned level crossings. One reason for noise, because they have to hoot every time they are crossing a level crossing. Across India, we are replacing with manned crossings and gradually also going for underpasses and overbridges. But there will be no unmanned level crossing on any main route by Ganpati this year.
I think it's wonderful to hear, because I, as a trustee of CRC, know that for 25 years at least they have been fighting for it. Walter will vouch for that.
But by Ganpati, this will be history.
Fantastic.
And I think all are working. What is the deadline of Central Railway? Unmanned is zero. So if there is a level crossing, there will be a gate mitra over there. Aapka Western Railway ka? You have appointed gate mitra. So wherever they were unmanned, to avoid that hooting and screaming of the train and people travelling during that time, we put in gate mitras. And we are encouraging states to share with us and convert to an underpass or an overhead road. But your other two points, madam, about bhajan mandali, among some here Mumbai kar, aapko Moneylife mujhe kuch sujhav de iske bare mein. I know for a fact that you can't, that they are an institution which are as much a part of the Indian Railways than the railways itself. So I am not so sure that that's going to stop. They travel 1.5-2 hours. This keeps them engaged, busy. I'm not in a mood to stop those bhajan mandis. And for those who are very, very concerned about their noise, possibly metro may be a better travel mode or some other way. But it will be very unfair on me to kill the legacy or the you know, some things which are very intrinsic to Mumbai. Already there are enough activists who want to stop Dahiyandi also, want to stop Ganesh Chaturthi, want to stop all the processions on Eid. We are not amongst that. We want to encourage India's rich culture and heritage.
On this noise part, I have a small request, because I have seen Mumbai track, not only thousands, lakhs of people cross the track every day. People are walking on the track. Thousands and thousands, whenever particularly Thana and Dombivli. So my motorman has to continuously sound the horn. Madam, he has to continuously sound. And I think that's the biggest source of noise pollution. My request is, if people have to, we are launching a lot many campaigns, they should not cross the track. They are not only crossing, they are walking like they are walking the park. So that makes motorman continuously sound the horn, and that's the biggest source of noise, not the speaker on the platform. We are
bhajan mandali ke sound se koi hamare kaan mein nahi honge. Mobile phone ka use karenge to kaan mein nahi
jayega. My question is more towards IRCTC. एक बार गलती से मैंने दो ईमेल एड्रेस यूज कर लिए, तब से 2010 तब से लेके मैं आईआरसीटीसी से सर्च कर रहा हूं, दे आर नॉट अलाउइंग मी टू बुक टिकट्स एट ऑल. परेशान करके रख दिया, कम से कम
अपने बिजनेस में आपको
यहाँ पे बैठ जाओ सर,
ऐसी समस्या हो तो आप क्या करोगे बताओ ना, क्या करोगे मुझे बताओ बॉस।
अभी जो काम मैं कर रहा
हूं आई टेल यू आईआरसीटीसी क्यों बताता हूं आपको, आईआरसीटीसी क्यों नहीं करती है आपको मालूम है, जब ट्रेन बुकिंग शुरू होती है पहले 2 मिनट के अंदर पूरी की पूरी ट्रेन बुक हो जाती है, आर यू अवेयर ऑफ दैट, यू नॉट अवेयर, आई टेल यू पीपल आर, हमने अभी सीबीआई को लगा रखे हैं, आरपीएफ सब वी आर ट्राइंग टू क्रैक डाउन ऑन दैट, people have created algorithms just like some people have done in NSC so 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 that you have created exchange hai waise
acha
acha but algorithm bana ke touts are booking all the tickets using fresh IP address and fresh email and through a computer program 2 minute mein puri train book kar lete hain aur genuine passengers ko fir black mein bhejte hain, I am trying to crack down on all of that, to usme ye type ki samasyaon mein jaise hi main khuli chhut dunga to ye doubts wapas aake bade paimane pe karenge, our effort is to serve the consumer, but agar aapka genuine case hai boss, ek IRTC ke liye ek naya email ID banane ko 30 seconds nahi lagenge.
I think we go to the next question, we'll take this offline. Yeah, Mr.
Gadda? Sir, Bandra Terminus, even after the last like 15-20 years it's operative. Lekin aaj bhi situation bahut hi kharab hai. I just used it last fortnight. And same with Dadar Terminus. Dadar Terminus approach is only, there is only one approach to, so if you can do something about that. And one more thing, Curry Road station is equally dangerous for, you know, the same tragedy can happen at Curry Road.
You know, Curry Road station pe, because of the urgency, I got the army to come and build a bridge. Ek to hissa ban gaya hai na already. Aap logon ne jo banaya wo to ban gaya hai. Ab dusra army bana rahi hai. Aapko jankari hai. Main naam nahi lena chahunga kyunki it will be unfair. As they say in Parliament, if the person is not there to defend himself, you can't take the person's name. But are you aware that we could not start the work in time? बिकॉज एक छोटा पीस ऑफ लैंड चाहिए था, पहले तो एक प्ले ग्राउंड था उसमें वो एग्जिट हो सकता था, तो वहाँ के लोकल लोगों ने इतना तंग किया कि थोड़े दिन तक तो वही झगड़ा विवाद चलता रहा, वी हैड टू अबॉर्ट द आइडिया, 2% तो प्ले ग्राउंड का यूज हो रहा था, 2% मुंबई के पैसेंजर्स की सेफ्टी के लिए, 2% द आर्मी गाइड टोल्ड मी, पर वहाँ के लोगों ने लेने नहीं दिया। खैर 5 करोड़ खर्च के हमने दूसरा एक प्लॉट आइडेंटिफाई किया, थोड़ा सरकार में प्रोसेस होता है, ऐसा तो नहीं है कि मैं अपना चेकबुक निकालूं 5 करोड़ का चेक लिख दूं और ले लूं, पर प्रोसेस शुरू कर दिया और हमने कहा कि हमारा सामान रखते तो आर्मी के लोग जो सामान ब्रिज के लिए लाए थे वो रखने की कोशिश की तो चौकीदार आ गया कि भागो यहाँ से यार, सामान भी नहीं रख सकते, पहले पैसा दो। ये है मुंबई की सेंसिटिविटी फॉर मुंबईकर्स। मैंने हॉस्पिटल जिस दिन गया हूं 27 नवंबर मैंने स्वयं फोन किया जब पता चला ऐसा हुआ है, और हम हमारी लीडरशिप ऐसे नहीं है कि ऑर्डर देते हैं, हम खुद करते हैं। मैंने फोन किया तो मुझे बताया गया कि हमको सरकार पे भरोसा नहीं है, पेमेंट मिलने में बहुत तकलीफ होती है, इसके पहले पैसे आएंगे फिर हम कहेंगे चला। यह है सेंसिटिविटी मुंबईकर्स की मुंबई के बारे में। एंड फिर हमने मैंने उनको कहा कि अच्छा मैं कोल इंडिया से सीएसआर में, मैंने उनको कहा एक्चुअली कि 250 मीटर जमीन तो आपको सीएसआर में दे देनी चाहिए, आपके पास भगवान की दया से और जो भी पुण्य किया होगा कभी ना कभी उससे आपके पास शायद लाखों करोड़ होंगे, हजारों करोड़ तो है, 5 करोड़ तो सीएसआर में दे दीजिए। पर जब कोई फायदा नहीं हुआ तो मैंने कहा कोल इंडिया से 5 करोड़ का चेक लिख दो सीएसआर का, पर वो नहीं करना पड़ा क्योंकि हमारे अधिकारियों को उनसे ज्यादा दिल धड़कते हैं आप लोगों के लिए, उन्होंने सब जितने कानून वानून है उसको शॉर्ट सर्किट करके अगले दिन मैं हॉस्पिटल में था, मुझे बताने आए थे जीएम साहब कि हमने सब आज 5 करोड़ का चेक दे दिए, जगह ले लिए और काम शुरू करना।
Thank you very much for this answer. We really appreciate it. And congratulations to the railways for doing it. I'm sure these things happen. So, one last question.
I think
the gentleman behind, come in front, sir, and please ask a question. I think we'll leave it at this. I know there's too many questions, but please be waiting for it.
Can I ask a question?
After Bhaskar. Bhaskar, second last, Arun Bhaskar, and then.
Okay, the question is basically this, sir. At a time when you're talking about digitization, why can't you have access controls at stations, like in metros, like in the monorail, where you have an Oyster card which is already pre-filled, you don't have to buy tickets, you just go in, go out, wherever you want.
But I'm delighted at the idea and I'm happy to start introducing it. I hope Moneylife Foundation and all the 59,000 members will come and stand at every station and help me regulate and manage the traffic and the fast inflow and outflow of passengers in the congested environment that each station today operates in. Because around each station, the city has grown like anything. But at the same time, we are experimenting with some stations. We have decided to start that. But I will look for support from all of you. Because there is going to be a lot of resistance to that from the people. But please do support us when we do that.
I think you involve us and we would be happy to do that. Last question.
Piyushji, since you are doing a good job, I would like to bring your attention to Konkan Railways and Southern Railways. Now, bogies as old as 50-year-old bogies are pushed onto the Konkan Railways like Netravati Express, where there is no charging points also. So, it is a request that in the forthcoming budget, some allocations for development of Konkan and Southern Railways, some allocation be made. And those bogies are, if you see, they are more than 50-year-old.
Thank you. I think the best way to end today evening is by responding to this question. Because you will be delighted to also know a new piece of information. It will reflect both the changing mindset of the railways and the changing style of it. One of the first few analyses that I was able to do when I became minister showed that there are two designs of bogies in the railways. One is called an ICF design, integrated coach factory design, and one is an LHP design, which is too complicated a German name for me to remember. Lichmann, something, Bosch or something like that. So they'll tell you afterwards. LHP design. The ICF design is a weak design. It doesn't have a coupler technology at the end. The structure is relatively weaker. And therefore, when we do an analysis of fatalities that have happened, in accidents, and accidents look happen everywhere. The other day there was an accident in Washington. Before that there was an accident, I think, in France. Before that there was a potential averted disaster in Japan. So this is something which, much as we would like to, and we aspire for zero accidents, happens often all. But in the ICF design, bogies tend to go one on top of the other, and the fatalities are high. In the LHP design, by and large they have said, and the statistics show that fatalities are very, very rare and far between. Am I right, gentlemen? So, one of the decisions that I took in the first month itself was that Indian Railways is going to discontinue manufacturing those ICF coaches from June 2018. Only whatever was ordered stock we are buying. Only LHP will be made by the Indian Railways, and those old bogies and all will gradually get phased out. Now, I have about 58,000 coaches which are used in the passenger service, out of which only 5,000 are LHP today. So I have to replace 53,000 plus provide for the expanded requirements. Right? Today's pace of production would take me a century to do that. So what do I do? We have a factory, for example, in Raipur. It was designed for 1,000 coaches. And it has just come on stream. It's a factory which was announced, I think, more than a decade or two ago. And you know who represents Raipur. So the name is Raipur, but the location of Raipur project is in Amethi, the parliamentary constituency Amethi. It was announced many, many years ago, over a decade ago, foundation stone, but factory didn't have foundation stone, I don't टूटा फूटा हमको किधर मिला था. But we set up a modern factory there with a capacity of 1,000 coaches. And now what are we doing? We are expanding that already. It's barely coming to operation. We are expanding that to 5,000 coaches. I have a factory in Chennai. Again, this was one of the reviews I did in the first month itself, or second month, September, October. Money, KM Money or something, his name is KM Money. He's the general manager. I think you should invite him once also. Delight to meet him. I was doing the review and he said, we are producing so many coaches every year, so many compartments of coaches every year. So many LHP, so many ICF. And that's, the decision was already taken that ICF is going to be stopped. So there I told him, I think they are making some 1600 or so coaches every year. This year's plan is 1600, of which 300-400 were LHP. I said next year plan for 3200, and next year plan for 6488. Upar double karke figure mujhe third year ka yaad hai. 6488 is his target, the outcome that we are working for. I settled that with him. He said, sir, kuch nahi hota hai. He's got very good Hindi, by the way. Tamilian, but very good Hindi. इधर साहब कुछ नहीं होता है इधर, तो मैं कब से 476 करोड़ रुपए का एक रेलवे कोर्ट में भेज रखा है, सैंक्शन में मुझे इतना टाइम लग जाएगा, मैं बढ़ा नहीं सकता. I said it's sanctioned now and here in Chennai. Paperwork will follow, you start the work. Then two things happened. Somewhere money misunderstood or something. He thought this doubling is only the LHP जो 250-300 बनाते हैं. उसको 500 करना है इस साल, 1000 अगले साल और 2000 तीसरे साल. But fortunately, I made notes of whatever meetings I do. तो ढूंढ ढांढ के वो पुराना नोट निकाल के मनी को दिखाया कि देखो मेरा पूरा LHP कोचेस 6488 था, तो ये ICF तो डिसकंटिन्यू हो रहा है. He said, I'll do it. That much commitment these people have. That 476 crore, the railway board put up the file to me for inclusion in next year's budget. I sent the file back. I said, मेरे जवान की कीमत क्या रहेगी? I've already sanctioned it. Now you put it up for current year's budget, supplementary mein aa. And it's gone in the supplementary. Money in the meantime and his team have done the entire tendering. The entire tendering is done. It's ready for financial bids to be opened. The day supplementary budget just was passed in this current session. As soon as that gets cleared, and it's already cleared, of course, Rajya Sabha mein the opposition disrupted the house, so we could not discuss it. But Lok Sabha has passed it, money pe rahe to clear ho jayega 15 din mein. We will have that 476 crore ready for it. He can open the financial bids and start. Have you heard of the railways with the legacy that Debashish showed on the screen before? Preparing for a tender even before the budget is signed. That's the new Indian railway that you have.